distinguished members of the panel, distinguished members of the CMA officials and directors of the Lanka Academy, and all the learning partners who have logged in today. So very good morning to all of you. Especially, I must thank very much to Lanka Academy for inviting me. Especially if you take my caliber, I am really passionate on, you know, sharing things, because I am a professionally qualified and academically qualified person. So I can give you a better perspective is what is academic life, what is professional life, based on my local and foreign experience. I have a lot of substance to share. So thank you very much for giving, you know, making that platform me to share to the new generation, because we must share when the time is right. When the seed is there for growing, we must give that input rather than after messing up all the careers. I mean, no point of giving career guidance to them. So for that, thank you very much for the organizers. And I must especially congratulate all the learning partners who have logged today, because if you are not passionate about your career, you might have not logged in, participated in such a program. So I must congratulate and tell all the guys, you're 50% done, because logging in, coming into this sort of opening session is itself a signal of a good career plan. So since I have been given a very short time, I try to, you know, move fast. This is a 57 slide presentation, but I am not going to go to each slide because of the time constraint. I have selected a base, very key, very important few slides for me to emphasize. So I think my introduction has been given, no point of going there. So setting with the philosophy, so I'll give you a life philosophy or a career professional. So as a career professional, let's say you have a matured career, you know, halfway through as a senior manager. By that time, you all have different types of life within you. I would say some sub-characters within you for you to become a super human being or a super career professional. Let's say, what are these lives? One life is physical. You need to be physically fit. You have to do exercise and physically fit. No diabetes, no heart attack. Family, you need to have a good family life, good kids. I mean, very mutual family life. Otherwise, life will be very imbalanced. Psychologically, you have to be psychologically very stable. There should be very good emotional intelligence. Spiritually, you should have a, you know, purpose of life. You should have a religion, you know, donations. That sort of spiritual life should be there for you to succeed. Another thing is academic. You should have qualification, you know, school, degree, MBA, blah, 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 CMA. All these qualifications you should gradually, you know, acquire. Otherwise, there won't be equilibrium. There should be social life. You should have friends. You should have corporations with you. You have social networks with you, association. Those affiliations should be there. Otherwise, you will get definitely failed. You should have an artistic family. You should, you know how to play a guitar, how to sing, dance, you know, go to recreation. All of that, that life should be there. Finally, there should be a superb, well-polished career life. You know, if you don't have that career life, most of these, you know, characters will get failed. So my first advice to all the learning partners is, if you want to have a balanced life, I'm not saying successful, a balanced, sustainable, well-blended life, you should have equilibrium of all these three. You may think, okay, having a career life without the social life, one day you will fail. Having a superb career life without family life, you will fail. Having a superb career life without a physical, you know, physique, you will fail. Having a superb career without psychological, you have become psychopatient. Your whole life will be a pandemonium. So before you start whatever life as a package, you should have all these in superb equilibrium. Otherwise, one day you will fail. Now, I've set the, you know, tone and the context for the presentation. Now, you must win all of these. Now, why career is so special? Because if you don't achieve a superb career, most of these, you know, elements will get indirectly affected. Suppose if your career is, you know, in a mess and you don't have a financial stability, your psycho will go, your physical fitness will go, your family will go for a six. So if you don't have a career focus, it will have a direct and indirect impact to all your substitute character. So that's why career planning is utmost important. Now, I am going to explain you. These are not in books. This is my context. I have developed this 40 rule mantra, how you can develop and grow your career plan. So I don't have time to go through all 40s. Let's say what are the key. So we are going to start with number one rule. So there are 40 rules. Let's start from number one. So this is a story from Alice in Wonderland. The girl, the Alice, asks, where should I go? This is a story. Yeah? Start from a little bit of literature. Where should I go? The cat says, where do you want to go? Alice says, I don't have an idea. Then cat says, it doesn't matter which way you talk or talk. That means if you don't have at least a vague vision where the direction that you want to propagate and go and navigate, the basics are not there. At least you should have a feeling, I'm going to end up as an accountant, I'm going to end up as an HR guy, I'm going to end up as a manufacturing guy, I'm going to end up as a lecturer, which field, blah, blah, blah. If you want to become a doctor, at least you should have a vague idea whether you will be an epidemiologist or a psychiatrist. So some vague idea should be there. Otherwise, you will be hovering around here and there. So when I asked this question, many of the people that I met, because I do career coaching, they told me, sir, I want to become a good manager. I want to become a good professional. I want to become a good human being. All are motherhood statements. So if you want to become a good career prospected guy, you should have at least some direction. This is my direction. You can't have a vague statement like I want to become a good general manager, a good professional. It doesn't have any substance. So you should have a clear direction where you want to go. Let's say another thing. Now, for you to choose what is the direction, you should pick up some discipline. Finance, management, HR, marketing, there should be one discipline. So I am giving some clues as rule number two. While you're choosing these disciplines, maybe a doctor, maybe a engineer, what are the factors you should master? What are the factors you should consider? Number one factor is how far you like that profession. If you want to become a doctor, how far your heart like to become a doctor. Otherwise, there is no passion, no career progression will be there. And where are your strengths? You have a singing strength, you have human strength, you have people skills. What are your key strength areas? From that, you'll have to navigate. Otherwise, if your passion is to become a singer, you don't have even a single a strength to sing, there can be a question mark. Future economic development. I mean, you must be willing to getting into pottery. Your passion is maybe in pottery, but if there is no economic development in pottery, there can be a question mark. I have seen people who get into different subjects based on the strength and the passion, but there is no economic development. Once you move halfway on the path, you feel like you're not getting enough income. So income also matter. In fact, the passion and the strength also matter. Future opportunities. Do you have future opportunities for pottery? Or do you have future opportunities for digital marketing? So you have to make sure what is the future subject to be in. Which field is growing? Which fields are growing? Now digital is growing, logistics is growing, but certain industries are not growing. Some people are really passionate to become getting into military, but halfway through they understand their strengths, the hard strengths are not there. So be careful. Finally, socially accepted. Some people want to become teachers. And halfway through, they feel themselves teachers are not recognized. So there's a huge issue. If you think the teacher is not socially, teacher is not socially recognized, there's a big question. If you think these fields are not socially recognized, suppose you want to become a guy who does pottery or who does some basic jobs, or you want to become a military guy. Halfway through, if you feel like that is not socially accepted, some issue. And you're getting into, a liquor manufacturing sort of a profession. And halfway through, realize everything is there, socially not accepted. My kid is not taken into school because his profession is not accepted. Huge issue. So before you find the, selecting the field, consider this social acceptance only, not only money and the passion. And things that you can enjoy, where your passion is. So consider all of these things before you select your discipline. Right. Now we are getting into another very important area where you will have to have a career mindset. What do you mean by career mindset? There's a job mindset, there is a career mindset. Job is, you know, I have clearly stipulated here, a temporary thing, which will give you some sort of an income. It's a short term, but career is a long term thing. Career refers to, you know, occupation, that means special training, you have to be trained, you know, job means often, you know, doesn't require any special training. You know, job is basically having some money. It's a short term thing. Most of the people, when I ask, what are you looking for? They basically say, sir, I'm looking for a job. So basically, job, if you're looking for a job, you are not in the career mentality. Job means to getting, you know, make a living. Job is, you know, becoming a security, becoming a short, you know, a guy who is looking for short-term income, you know, buying and selling, getting into a three-wheel and, you know, three-wheeler driving. It's a short-term, you know, money-making thing is job. So especially don't get into job mentality. Career mentality means you have career prospects moving forward. You will get developed, you will get promotions, you will get career exposure, you will get training, you will get different industry, you know, experience, and you will become an unmatchable character. That is called career. So don't go for short-term money-making, you know, jobs. So forget about job mentality. Now, this is the one of the most important mantra in this presentation. So I have asked you to select your core subject, you know, where your passion is, where you want to be. So your core subject, maybe let's say marketing. Your core subject is marketing. So don't think for you to become a chairman, you to become a managing director, you need to master all the subjects. It's not possible at all. Don't try to master all the subjects. Me as a career professional, I have mastered sales and marketing only. But I have sales experience. I have, you know, exposure and learning about HR. I have peripheral learning about logistics. I know very basics about, you know, marketing. I know very basics about manufacturing. For you to go and ask some, you know, good question from your manufacturing director. If some non-marketing thing is being presented, I know the challenge that I can give some challenging, you know, questions from logistics. So you select your core subject and be a master. Suppose you are in marketing, your core subject is marketing. There should be anyone in the company who should challenge your knowledge and exposure. You are the number one in marketing. But you can't say you don't know anything about sales. You can't say you don't know anything about HR. You can't say you don't know anything about finance. Finance, certain basic elements you should know. Logistics, R&D, different functions, planning, you should know basics. So when you're going through meetings and different seminars, exposures in the company, you will have to learn these elements. So then you will get the cross-functional exposure. Then this package you can sell in the future for different employees. If you say, sir, my core is, I don't know my core. My core is sales, marketing, HR. No. There can't be a core with many subjects. Core is only one or two subjects. You take me, sales and marketing is my core. So today you decide, check what is your core and master the core. Peripherally, you will get your other elements right. You know, 10 to 15 to 40% knowledge is enough, not 100%. But your core subject, 200% knowledge should be there. So this is the mantra you should drive your career. You can't say, I am a very good professional in marketing and HR. But for you to become a general manager, one core and peripheral, this thing, for you to become a board member, more than enough. Don't try to master all the subjects during your lifespan. You can't do it. There is no one who has mastered all the subjects. So this is a very, you know, misconcept all the people are having. I must master all the subjects. No. So dreaming is, you know, rule number five. Dreaming is very, very important, you know. If you don't have a dream, if you don't think the end result that you are going to end up, nothing would happen. So try to dream, because only if you dream, you will try to achieve. If you don't, you know, if you don't dream where you are going to be in, you know, 5 to 6 years time, you are not going to plan for that. So dream is important. and try to share your dream. I want to become a doctor. I want to become a professor. I want to become an engineer. So all the societies, your grandmother, your parents, your friends, all will help you because you know this child is going to become a general manager in a company. So all will help you. All will give you some exposures and opportunities here and there. So I have given you a basic dream. If you start as management intern, slowly you will become a general manager. You will have some sort of very vague dream. A simple dream is Why a plan is needed? So everyone is saying, why you should need a plan? You will carry on. Without a plan, you don't have a time plan. You don't have a deadline. You don't have a structure. You don't know what to be done, who will be done, what are the site support, what are the resources that you want to, what are the ingredients of this career plan. So obviously, for anything in your life, you don't have a plan in an Excel sheet, chances are 1% for you to execute. If you have a plan, even for anything, even for going on a trip will be successful. So have a rough, you don't have a, superb game plan. You should have a simple steps and action points. Where, what are you going to do, when and by whom, what are the resources? So you should have something in written, what I'm saying. So this is a very key slide, another slide in my presentation. So simple plan. You should have some sort of guideline where you're going to navigate. So you get a basic degree, then marketing intern, then management trainee, you will become a junior, brand manager, then acquire a professional qualification like, CMA here, some sort of, maybe CIMA or other professional qualification, then become assistant brand manager, then brand manager. So during your whole lifespan, you will get training, you will participate on different sessions, you will get exposure in different industries, different companies, different countries, different contexts, different times. So everything you should get these ingredients into your plan. So you should have this, picture in your mind, then you're very clear where you're going to be. Otherwise, without this picture, if you don't have, nothing would happen professionally. Otherwise, your career would be, will happen by default. Nothing would happen by default in your professional life. Unless otherwise you're going to get a lottery ticket vote. Then you will become a marketing manager. Then you will plan for a foreign exposure. Because if you want to become a managing director in a company, foreign exposure is must. So you should plan at least one stint in your life to work in a foreign country. Then regional marketing manager, then another professional qualification, maybe a PhD, maybe a DBA, maybe a MSc. Then you will become a marketing director, then regional marketing director, then sales director, then general manager, managing director, chairman, group chairman. Then you will, at the end of your life, you will become a consultant, you will become a resource person. If you have this plan in your mind, game is ready. Without this plan, nothing would happen. So I am asking you, I have a video, but I don't have a time to show you. Whatever you do, you should have that burning desire. Let's say Bhati and Santosh, they sing, Chitral Somapala, while they sing, the passion is pouring here and there. So if you don't have passion, even for cleaning, even for as a, garden cleaner or a sweeper, nothing would be successful in your career life. Whatever the profession or a job you do, do it with passion, do it with differentiation, then any career will get processed. So if you think after halfway through in your plan, if you think like your passion is not there, a lot of people, even it happened to me. I changed my career plans here and there. I got failed, got back to the previous. So you can take certain risk and check. If you feel like this path is not correct, if you keeping falling off track, it may be, it's not you, but maybe you're in the wrong track. You may be perfect because of the track issue. Because you think manufacturing is your passion, but halfway through you feel like, working with machines is not your passion. So don't waste time. Quickly get back, even after spending 10 years. Doesn't matter, go back to your passion, because you being in a non-passionate area will not lead you to anywhere. So halfway through, if you think you are not in the correct job, correct, industry, thank God, leave. Even if you're paid 1,000 times better than others, money doesn't matter halfway through. So leave. So it's another clue. Don't think you want to become a brightest person, batch top, a super bright guy for you to become a managing director. No. Look at your people who are, I can remember in my class, number one batch top they didn't get into the managing director positions. So all ordinary balanced people got into managing directors and chairman. Look at all these people. All these people were not first in the class, first in the batch, you know, a merit in MBA, no. All ordinary people, good entrepreneurs, but average, highly passionate, intelligent people. So if you think, I am not the brightest in the class, it doesn't mean you can't reach the top. So that's another myth. Even all these guys are ordinary people. So if you're ordinary, that will be a biggest qualification. Another good rule, rule number 10, you think halfway through, you know, after getting 10 years experience in a bank, in a same role, you may think, I have a lot of experience and my career should prosper. Wrong, wrong, wrong. Experience doesn't matter in this context. What matters is exposure. Exposure means, you know, exposure in 2-3 industries. You know, if you are a finance guy, exposure in a bank, exposure in FMCG company, exposure in a, you know, insurance company or another industry. You know, exposure in different cultures. You know, experience in one multinational, one local, you know, one foreign, you know, working in foreign countries, you know, experience as a manager, as a, you know, a technical guy, maybe as a consultant, maybe as a trainer. So all exposure, suppose you have 20 years experience in one company, in one job, it doesn't matter at all. But what the industry demands is people who have 2 years experience in, you know, in an FMCG company, 5 years experience in insurance company, another, if you get into the, you know, area called finance, you know, 2-3 industry, 2-3 company, different culture, foreign, and lots of exposure. Exposure is, you know, turning into results, not the experience. So don't try to be in one company, in one industry for long. If you don't get that exposure, better to change at least after 4 years to another industry or another discipline or another company, then your career blend will be perfect. You know, people are there, one company, one position for 25 years. The value that they are getting in the market is very less. But 20 years experience with a lot of exposure will give a lot of this. So most successful people, as I told you, not the brightest, you know, not the perfect. Successful people are most adaptable people. Once you get into the careers, if you are adapted to all the company environment, that is the success mantra. Not being the brightest, not the being the best. You know, it will be very difficult to be a perfectionist. So try to adapt. Adaptation will give career prospects. So don't think if you are super qualified. Now I have all the qualification in the earth. It doesn't mean that my career, you know, next promotion is guaranteed. Especially in, maybe in government sectors, if you get into this senior level qualification, you will get into directorship. In private sector, it is not a guarantee. You get thousands of qualifications, you will get into the next level. If qualification plus results, qualifications plus results and your exposure will drive you. So you acquire qualification. It itself alone will not make you the path. Smart work and hard work, I don't need to explain you. So if you want to become promoted in a company, only achieving your KPIs, only achieving your job function is not suffice. You need to get into leadership roles. You need to lead projects in the company. You need to show your wisdom. If you're a sales guy, you think achieving target consistently, you know, will give you wisdom. No, achieving target, okay, you will sustain in the job, but you should show how you drive the business, what is your strategy for the business, how you lead the team. Especially showing leadership and strategy is the key mantra for your performance. Some people are telling me, sir, I have been, you know, working hard along this, you know, 10 years in my life. I have achieved all my sales targets. Still, I am an area sales manager, not the head of sales. I told you, where was your leadership skills? Have you shown different strategic ways how you can build the business? And, you know, strategic moves, had you been a very, you know, positive character to the company? You had to show your positiveness to the company. Have you done any extracurricular projects in the company? Have you managed your boss properly? All these elements are pretty much important for you to get the next promotion. Only achieving your job target will not get you there. And if you want to have a good career, you have to network everywhere. Alliance Club, All Boys, that association, this association, lot of friends and lot of affiliations you will have. Otherwise, you won't get good leads to get information. And I've told you. You think if you have knowledge, you are a super knowledgeable person in an organization, that is not guaranteeing you a career prospect. You should, with the knowledge, you should make your knowledge into results. Without results, company will not recognize you. And you should do a job with satisfaction, just like this person. If you are not satisfied in your job, your career prospects will not come. So if you don't like the job, you should some or other try to like the job, otherwise leave the job. So your qualifications, your all these things, you should add continuously. It will be adding spices to your this thing. And get into other projects like maybe Chili's Awards Committee, NASCO Awards Committee, Slim Brand Excellence, you know, different, you know, organization, alumni, all boys. Get into this and show your leadership skills. You know, develop your leadership skill. That will really add value to your career. So I think my time is... and try to become a very good, popular, you know, brand in the company. If you take Mr. Kishore Gomez, Ravi Jayawardhan, Mr. Arvind Pereira, those are iconic brands in the industry. High demand is there for these people. You know, the best way to check your brand equity is go to Google and type your name. At least nothing is coming. You don't have an equity, basically. So, some pitfalls in your career path. If you're in a comfortable job for a longer time, no promotions, you have to quit. Same company for many, many years without progression, you'll have to quit. You know, your juniors reaching into your level, your subordinates are has come to your level, going up. My God, you need to take some action. You know, your peers getting promoted above you. You try to, you know, say boss to them. Major pitfall, you'll have to take a call. Don't be in that company. You'll take a drastic this thing. And most people think becoming a nice person in a company is give you, you are a nice person, you know, very religious person. No, we need people who can bring results. Otherwise, no career path. Some good people are there. I am very good, loyal. Loyalty, you know, will not mature, will not get, you know, acclimatized. Unless otherwise, you will provide results. So I'll stop my presentation by giving you a very, very, very valid, you know, advice given to me, my senior schoolmate, Deshamanya, former cricket captain, Mr. Roshan Mana, one of my very good friends. I told him that I'm going to tell this to this forum today. His mantra is, it doesn't matter whether you win or lose. If you're going to get a promotion or not, if you're going to get the target achieved or not, as a company, they won't much worried about. But they worried about what matters is how you play the game in the final over. If you have 30 runs to win in the final over, you feel like defeat is in your doorstep. But in the final over, how do you manage without stress, cool and calm, very strategically, without getting stressed up? Even sometimes I have gained experience in my lifespan, companies, you know, getting into bankruptcy. But how people are trying to, you know, recover that when we are not getting business in the COVID. You know, we know that we are not going to get even the salary, but how we drive the business with passion at the last over, how you play the game positively, how your attitude, you know that you're going to lose the job next month, but till that, how you played the game is being observed by the superiors. So make sure your effort, how you approach, how you play the game is observed by your bosses. So be very careful. If you think you're going to lose the match, don't give up the match till then. Show them that you're driving the match, even the defeat is guaranteed. So with that, I would like to conclude my this thing for a Q&A session. But if somebody gives me some more time, I can even go for the whole day. Rashmi?
Sir, you can take your time, sir.
All right. Okay. Then I'll go to another very... give me an indication where I want to stop. I have so many items to cover. Now... If all understand this particular grid as a professional, you know where to pitch. If you want to play a century, this is the mantra. If you want to prospect progress in a company, you will have to, you know, compete with your peers. If you are a brand manager, your peers will be there. Other company guys will be there. All are there to get the promotion, maybe in a few months' time. Or few years time. How company, professional companies assess your performance in two ways for you to evaluate yourself for a promotion. I'm telling you for a promotion. this particular axis is your performance. Let's say you are a sales guy. You are continuously achieving your sales target. That means your performance is towards this side. If you are a brand manager, you are continuously gaining market share. You are continuously growing your brand. Your performance is high. This axis is performed. Here, your leadership potential, promotions are not given to the high performer. When the cricket captaincy was given to Sachin Tendulkar, it was a disaster. But Sachin Tendulkar was a performer. Sanat Jayasuri also were a performer, but not superb captain. Sachin Tendulkar was a performer, but not a good captain. If you take Kumar Sangakkara Mahela, performance, leadership also was there. So if you want to achieve the next level, don't think your performance itself will matter. No, your leadership, how you can manage team, how you can convince your bosses, how without using your extra, position power, how you can manage stakeholders, how you can drive your vision, your passion with your teams and drive teams. Some people are superb performers individually. He knows, sir, I know how to work individually and I know how to do my work, but I can't influence people. I don't know how to get stuff done from others. Then, my dear, you can't get into the next level. So you need to develop your leadership here. Oh. So without leadership, having career qualifications, being a popular guy, being a good guy, results, not drive. But you will get the bonus. You will get some salary increment. Your bosses will say you're a good performer, but promotions are not given. Captaincy will not be offered to you. So you will have to drive all these. Some people are, they are high performers. Leadership qualities are this thing. They are not considering you for a promotion. Some people are very good leaders here, superb leaders. But performance, they know how to lead, but they don't know how to bat. They know how to lead. So your promotion is not guaranteed, but you will survive. But you don't have both. You will be asked to leave. You will be sacked. If your leadership is good, but performance is very bad, like you will be getting red notice. Here also red notice. If your performance is mediocre, leadership is zero. You will get a red notice. But here is the most people, you and me are there. We have both 50-50. Some people are there, performance is mediocre, leadership is high, good for next level. Some people are there, a leadership mediocre, performance is very high. Good candidate for the next promotion. Here is the promotable material. High performance, high strategy, high leadership. So if your boss is given 10 guys to consider for a promotion, if I am the boss, I'll take this guy. Next level, this guy, not this guy. So if you can try to be in these three quadruples, your career is, your promotion is somewhat like guaranteed. So don't think only your performance or only you being a leader, you will get promotion. So I have told you how promotions are given in a company. So I'll give you another set of hints. You want to gain equity in the company, gain popularity. You need to be showcased as a best guy, super performer leader in the company. Otherwise, you won't get a career progression. Some guys are there, super performers, but no one knows. So for you to get good, popularity, equity in the company, you should always have positive attitudes about the company. If you criticize company outsiders, there'll be an issue. You have to be loyal to your company, contribute additional projects. Most of the time, people are doing only his work area. No, you will have to attend to other functional, non-functional, projects. Maybe a religious ceremony, maybe a leadership program, maybe a trip, maybe another, cross-functional thing, maybe a company event. You should be a part and parcel of that event. Don't try to stick to your work area and go home. And most of the time, if you get an opportunity, speak. Be a good speaker in forums. Don't try to avoid. High association with senior managers. If you happen to meet your managing director, director, don't hide. I have seen some people, if your manager director is approaching you to have a few words, you try to hide yourself. No, always try bravely, meet them and have a chat. Another hint, if your CEO, the manager, or chairman knows you by name, can remember you by name, that's a good indicator. You know, and during meetings, you have ample of meetings in a company. During meetings, a lot of people just participate and doesn't add value. During meetings, you have to talk, challenge, and add value. Then only people will pick up for you for next promotion, no career prospects. If you just lie in a meeting without add value, no way. And if you're given some risky task in company, you know, deliver a speech when your regional director comes here. You know, take a leadership in a company, very vigilant project. Now, if you take myself, I am the leader of company business continuity plan. Even I sometimes, you know, give direction to even chairman. So company gave me that. It's a huge risk. If I fail, some or other, my job also will be in shambles. So I took this risk and some or other sustained. And always try to stand up. You know, try to be get highlighted in your company forums. Then people will get recognized. People will know you, your popularity, your brand equity will be very good. And always try to accommodate some requests from other departments. If your direct finance department is telling you to, you know, get certain things done, some information, try to help them. Try to have, you know, intra-company harmony and, you know, collaboration. Yeah. Now you think you are a promotable, high performing, you know, high strategic type person in the company. How do you recognize? What are the tests? I'll give you a few hints. Now, if you are nominated for special projects in a company, that gives you indication that company has recognized you as a high potential guy for a promotion. If you are nominated for foreign trips for certain training and all, company, you're in a good, you know, positioning in a company mindset. If your name is, you know, nominated to represent company for different events, different conventions, you are a performer in a company. If you are nominated for networking sessions, you know, okay, there is a networking session with the president. You know, Dinesh Amangoda will represent HEMAS. That means company has recognized you. And when to change your job or the company? There is a mantra. If you think you don't have anything more to absorb from this company, suppose you are a, you know, marketing manager, 10 years experience in one company as a marketing guy, you have grasped all the experience in that company. And you are not seeing promotional prospects in the company. You are not highly recognized. You don't see the next level. You don't see a, you know, slot for you in the next this thing. 10 years in the company. Your career progression is very slow. Your learning is also very miniature. Contribution for you to the company almost zero. You are just doing the same thing over and again. The exchange, the value exchange is almost come to a standstill. That means company doesn't get anything from you. You don't get anything from the company. That means company don't need you, simply. They're just paying you the salary because you don't leave. Then you will have to think for a career change. Change the company or ask for a departmental change. If you're in a conglomerate, ask for a, you know, sub in another, you know, company in the firm. Or get hold of a headhunter and this thing and check why this is happening. Maybe you must be stagnant in the same role. You must be knowing, it must be not into this career progression mindset. So if you're in that stature, immediately you should change your company, you should change your industry. Do according to your master plan, do a career change. Otherwise, don't sit in this company. I'll give you another metaphor. If you can see, Dave Watmore was a very performing coach in the Sri Lankan team in 96-97. Who drove Sri Lankan cricket team into the 1996 World Cup victory. But over a period of time, he gave all his tactics and strategies to the boys. After that, the equilibrium didn't happen. There is nothing much for him to give. So Sri Lankan government had to change the coach, take another coach. He went to another, you know, country, maybe Bangladesh, started a new learning curve. Just like that, if you feel like there are no career progression, only the salary is, you know, given, no value addition to both the parties, take a risk and change the career. There is no mantra, change the career. If you feel like you can go to another. But a lot of people who got stagnant in one company 10, 15 years became super performers in the next company. So don't be in one company if you're stagnant. So, you know, known people, known characters who had really good career plans, very good popularity in the industry, very good equity in the industry. These careers were built not by default. They had a plan. They practiced, because I know all these, you know, CEOs. I know the path. I know the strategies they took to come to this level. So that's what I'm sharing. So you will have to have a nice career, you know, plan to move. Otherwise, nothing would happen in by default. Another thing is, in your corporate life, perception is basically matter. Suppose you work 24 hours, but people will not perceive, think you are a good performer. It's a huge question. That means you have to showcase your knowledge, be in meetings, speak up, speak to CEOs, speak to your directors, and make sure you are a performer. Not only your boss knows that, whole company knows that you have a good perception. You are a talented guy. You are a visionary guy. You know, a promotable guy. So make sure even you are a good performer in front of your boss, but you will have to showcase as a performer in front of your whole company. Have a good perception. So that covers a major part of the presentation, organizers. I can take one or two questions if there are. And I want to emphasize the fact that if you want to, you know, prosper in your career, always try to build. Number one, you know, ingredient is positive attitude towards everything. Suppose you're asked to leave for XYZ matter. Suppose you're asked to leave, you're sacked from the company. Think positively. I've got some experience in my life in one you know, particular function. I became not a failure, but I was not performing very well. So I decided to leave from that place to another department, because I felt that my passion, because I had been a career, you know, a sales and marketing professional, some or other company wanted me to get into supply chain. But I felt like supply chain, you know, playing, you know, numbers and figures, planning was not my forte. I got very, you know, upset. My performance didn't come. My passion towards work, my likelihood towards work failed day by day. So I told my management, I'm not going to end up prosperly in this, you know, particular field. But at that time, I had spent four valuable years in that particular function. But I said, doesn't matter. I have been, you know, I have sent some foreign countries also to get some training. I said, if I need, I can pay you for that training. I want to shift to another area. So by force, I went back to my previous area. So basically, I went back. It was a drawback in my life. But within 1 year, I recovered the whole thing. So if you feel like you're not in the right job, immediately take a risk and go back to your passion area. You must have taken a good risk to get into another good this thing. But if you feel that is not in your blood, please leave. So think positively. If you want to leave, leave. And if your department head thinks you're not performing, make some good point. That's an indicator that you're not in the correct, you know, passionate area. Second thing is, always have the growth mindset. Don't become complacent. Suppose I have seen so many, you know, career, you know, professionals, they have told me, sir, now I have come to a saturation in my life. I have achieved everything. I'm qualified. Now I am a general manager in the company. Now I am done. I'm ready to rest. No one is ready to rest till you die, because your validity, if you are not updated yourself, if you are not in the growth mindset, always you have to think, if you are a general manager today, next 2 years' time, you will have to become a senior general manager. Yes, we have some questions. Yeah, I am ready for the questions. Shamal, you have a question? Yes, Shamal, go ahead. Shamal, you are muted. Shamal.
Yes, so thank you very much. So Dr. Dinesh is sharing your views on the career development. So yes. I have one question regarding the point that you that you mentioned. So you mentioned when we start the career, we have to focus on one path.
Yeah.
But sometimes I have seen that some people carried away because most of the CEOs of organizations, yeah, heads have different qualifications, one from marketing, one from HR, one from finance. And because of that, sometimes young professionals carried away and they thought, they actually think that should be the way. So I would like to get some insights from you about that.
Yeah, I think very challenging, very good question. Thank you very much for asking that question. Yes, even Shamal, you as a professional, if your core area is marketing, no one will stop you to get, you know, a legal degree, a digital marketing degree, a degree in logistics. You know, I mean, even I can do. You have one degree in marketing, another degree in, you know, finance, another degree in logistics, another, you know, qualification in, you know, some other area. You can do it and you will get passed also. But how can you be a co? If you are a singer, you are a co baila singer, your co is baila. If you try to master oriental music, if you try to master Bharata, if you try to master, you know, Kavigi, Karattagi, but your co is this thing, you will learn, but you can't master. And the time that you spend to master all this area within this, you know, maximum, you will work for 70 years. So you will become a failure. But try to build your core. Don't, you know, let anyone to challenge your core. If you fail in your core, you will get failed. But if you have peripherally good this thing, that will be a driving engine for you to become a CEO one day. Show me a CEO in a company who has mastered. Masters means gathered qualification. Mastered means who had performed in so many disciplines. No, I maximum one or two, not even three. Because you can't humanly do it. It's not possible. If you try to do it, you will try to. I have seen so many people. I'm trying to cover master finance, then get into marketing and finance, HR finance. But at the end of 70, you will master 5 areas, but you will retire as a manager. So I have seen people with that mentality. I am guaranteeing the failure. All the people, Mr. Aravinda Pereira, you know, Mr. you know, Ravi Jayavardhana, all have asked from them one core area. Master, but they know. You know, even if you take my managing director, you know, he's a finance guy, but he can challenge anything in sales and marketing. You know, he comes and challenge even more nitty-gritties in sales in me. But his core is that. From that core, he has built. You can read, you can gather, but always, while you expand in the core, expand in the periphery. Don't try to get a periphery higher than, you know, this thing. There is no market value for that. And another signal, if you have a higher, you know, market value, if no headhunters are calling you, no job offers are given to you, you know, no one asks you to come and do any projects, promotions are not given to you for over the last 5-6 years, you know, no one has asked you to come and join a project in your company, and all your peers are, you know, getting promoted, that is a big indication that huge issue is there. You should consult a career counselor. So if you have a good career counselor, career counseling in the early stage, that is just like this, that is the best, you know, fertilizer in the early stage. Getting this career counseling at the age of, let's say, 50, you know, it can at some way, it'll be too late. So that's why I told you all the participants here, congratulations, because you hit the ball at the right time. You know, hitting the ball at the last over, last ball, you will get only 6 runs, but you will have to get 30 runs. So early the better. Have that rough plan early the better. Plan, plan, plan. Doesn't matter. Whatever failures. Suppose you plan to become a doctor. Halfway through, you thought your passion is to become a salesman. Forget about doctorship. Don't think about that 10-year waste. But if you think that 10-year as a waste, and if you try to become a doctor for the rest 40 years, your rest 40 years is going to be a calamity. So even after halfway through, after spending 20 years, if you feel like this is not passion, leave it. That's the key thing. If you don't like the job, don't like the company, don't blame the company and be there. If your boss doesn't like you, if the company doesn't appreciate you, company always look at the bad side in you, immediately leave. don't blame the company and stay in the company. I have seen so many people blaming the company 24 hours, blaming the boss, blaming the, you know, during corridor talks. What maximum you do is blame the company, getting the salary as well. So if you want to blame the company, don't stay in the company. If you think you're not paid, you're not appreciated, promoted, given recognition, given not given training and all, immediately get an opportunity. But your mind knows you are not getting opportunities from the outside, and ask yourself why. Why not headhunters are calling you? Why not you are being promoted? Your boss will never tell it to your face, my dear friend, you are a non-performer, I can't promote you because you are a weak guy. No one will tell you, but you will have to get that indication. They have indicated, giving a bad rating to you, not promoted, no foreign training, no salary increment, nothing means companies indicating you to go. Then you go or try to have a rigorous career plan to recover. Best thing is if you mess up in one company, company will not trust you very hardly. So best thing is leave that company.